Today on the 52 FAQ, is your skimmer performing at its peak? Hi, I'm RT, your host of BRStv's 52 FAQ, where we answer all kinds of reefing questions from our popular series, 52 Weeks of Reefing. Today we're answering James Edwards' question, is there any advantage to having a skimmer that has far more gallon range than the actual gallons you have in your tank? Good question, James. Honestly, I usually only use the manufacturer gallon rating as a rough guideline. When choosing the right skimmer for your setup, you want to choose its size based on the amount of food you feed your aquarium. If you feed your tank heavily, then choosing a skimmer that's considered oversized will offer the best performance. On the flip side of that, if you tend to be a light feeder, then choosing an oversized skimmer will usually result in less than desirable results. In a given water volume, there may not be enough dissolved organic compounds, proteins, or waste in the tank to maintain a stable foam head inside of the larger skimmer body, and will have trouble pushing any foam produced up through the neck. Generally, this shows itself as the foam surging. Periods of foam production followed by the skimmer hardly producing any, resulting in less than desirable performance, inefficiency, lack of skimmet production, and difficulty to tune the skimmer. More or less, the larger the skimmer, the larger the pump, which increases turnover through the skimmer. The body is also larger, which results in more foam production, capability to push more foam through the neck, and a greater filtration capacity. I'd say in most cases, reefers tend to be heavier feeders due to a large amount of fish, and choose a skimmer that has a higher rating than their system volume, not only with their current capacity in mind, but also the future of their tank. A larger skimmer means you don't need to worry when your plans change and you add more fish than you originally planned for, adding more water volume to the system, or even upgrading to a new tank entirely. A couple quick tips, if you're someone that would rather have a more user-friendly skimmer setup that's simpler to tune and is easier to achieve foam production, then you might want to consider using a skimmer that's considered undersized. Not only will the neck of the skimmer likely be smaller and easier for foam to condense and spill over into the collection cup, but it'll require less adjustment as the concentration of proteins in the smaller skimmer body produce a more consistent head of foam. Granted, you're sacrificing a bit of performance for ease of use. Additionally, one of the warnings I see quite a bit when planning to overskim your tank is the potential to skim out trace elements from the water column when using too large of a skimmer. However, skimmers remove dissolved waste from the tank before it has a chance to break down into ammonia and nitrate, and while skimming wet may remove some water from the aquarium and along with it some trace elements, the overall effect on them is likely pretty small. In my experience, the benefits more than outweigh any potential issues. If you're interested in learning more about protein skimmers in the reef aquarium, do yourself a favor and check out week 17 of 52 Weeks of Reefing, Protein Skimmers, Selecting and Tuning the Best. Don't forget, answering your questions is what the 52 FAQ is all about, so ask us something you want to know in the comments area down below. See you soon with the next 52 FAQ.